At Blackfoot Communications, our mission is to connect people, businesses, and communities, bringing a world-class fiber network to homes, communities, and businesses of all sizes, ensures Montanans have access to fast, reliable, and secure internet and phone services. Are you ready for fiber internet? To find out if fiber is coming to your area, visit goblackfoot.com/readyforfiber. Connect to more with Blackfoot Communications.
Some flashes in the first half. We didn't finish a couple drives, but we knew if we can keep leaning on them, we could potentially break them. I think that's what happened. You know, they kept fighting. That's a good team. That's a good program.
Jack,
but really proud of the guys. That was a tremendous effort. You know, and it wasn't easy. You know, we had to fight through some stuff. We weren't perfect by any means, but I think the forward thinking nature of this crew found a way tonight.
Yeah, it was a heck of a matchup. We're looking forward to it for the whole season. But Sacramento State is dangerous on offense, and your defense rose to the occasion.
Yeah, made some big plays. You think about the turnovers, John's return for a touchdown when we were trying to still find our way. Big turnover. You know, we just had turned the ball over. We get it right back. Great play by Miles Jackson, tipping the ball and up to Rylan Ortt. So, you know, and they were bound to do some things. They really led the clock there at the end. We didn't want to give up that last score, but come out on top. I think we were the more physical team tonight, and that's what we aim to be every week. But that was a hard team to do that against, and super proud of the guys.
Now you had that 90-yard drive. You got that kickoff return. It started on the 10-yard line. You took it all the way down. That had to feel good for your offense to get that score.
Yeah, they did a good job making the kick return game complicated with those squibs, and those are tough to handle. But I think the way we were moving the ball offensively in that second half, regardless of the field position, our guys were going to do what they needed to do. And yeah, that drive in particular, I think turned the tide back in the direction.
And you had some guys step up. Guys got dinged up here a little bit today, but your second guys got in there and made the difference.
Yeah, that's next man up mentality. You know, we practice the way we do so we can put our guys in position to be ready when they're ready to answer the call. And I think about Miles Jackson, Ryan Largan, those two in particular, big games by them. Blake Stillwell had to go out there a bunch. That's the nature of how we're built, and you love to see it when it plays out the way it did tonight.
Doesn't get any easier next week going into Moscow.
No, we gotta enjoy this one. Get our rest when we get our rest, and start putting the plan together tomorrow, and get those guys back ready to go on Monday.
Were they lining up off the line of scrimmage quite a bit defensively, and if so, why did you think they were doing that?
Well, perhaps. I know they were throwing a lot of different things at us. I think that's where sometimes things take a while. I think our guys, if an offensive line can get in a rhythm, I think ultimately that happened. They weren't just traditional and lining up and putting four guys' hands in the ground and playing defense. You throw enough things against the wall, you hope things stick, and ultimately though our physical nature won out. A couple really big runs, Tommy, Sean, certainly Julius is the hurdle run there, that was something else at a time when we really needed to answer their score. That was an interesting game to say the least.
I watch college football all day. There's so much volatility in it. You guys seem to be so steady. How are you guys able to do that?
Well, I think all three of our units, our offense and defense, are capable on any night to do the job. We don't lean heavily on one unit or the other. By no means were we perfect tonight in any one phase, but I like the nature of this team. We're a pretty complete team, and I think that showed tonight. And to win the type of games as this season continues to go on, we need to have those complete efforts. Like I said before, I think we've got a really forward-thinking bunch of guys. They can put a bad play behind them, and they can put a good play behind them and go on to the next play. So that was evidence over and over again tonight.
Coach Johnson said he wanted his unit to wear the other team out. It seemed like by the end they did that.
Yeah, absolutely. I know they gave us a short field that last stretch, but those last couple times we had the ball, and even the very last time just getting that first down. We won the battle up front. We limited their running game. I know their bigger plays were here and there, run in pass, but you know, I think we definitely won the battle up front.
You've now beaten every team in the Big Sky in your career. I guess, what does that mean, if anything, to you now?
Well, I think we're doing things the way we need to. Whoever we play, who's up front our schedule, we beat them. You know, I think this is big for our guys. You know, you don't play a team for a couple years, you share a title, all those things. But it's still about this year's team continuing to stack up these wins and know how important it is to have a consistent effort each week, so we give ourselves a chance to keep moving forward. You know, they're a good program. It just so happens it's the first time we played them in a while, and thankfully we came out on the right side.
Did you get an explanation as to why there was no review, or what happened?
They said it was cleared. I could have challenged all day. They told me it was cleared, and they apparently looked at it. We'll have to look at it and see how close it was, I guess.
Speaking of that play, I guess your defense recovering, forcing through the goal there, back-to-back interception.
Yeah, we call that sudden change. We just gave up a touchdown, and we have that turnover on special teams to limit them to a field goal. That was huge. You know, that's a tie game versus a four-point lead right there, and for our guys to come up, with that, you know, you kind of grasp that momentum back a little bit, even though we just turned it over and they scored. But yeah, tremendous job. I mean, that doesn't seem like that was that long ago. That was, you know, on the verge of a tie game. So yeah, again, that whole deal. You know, we move on. Marquis moved on. Guys trust him. We're going out there again and keep.
Ready?
I guess just beating this team that you guys haven't faced in a while, number three in the nation, is how gratifying.
Yeah, it's a really big win. We were talking about it. It's a program win. You know, it's the two. I think each program's only have one loss coming into this game in the last 2 years in the Big Sky. So, and if we hadn't played each other, it was a tie for conference in 2022 and 2021. It came down to the wire as well. Yeah, it's just a big win for this program. For the university, it kind of, you know, solidifies that we're a really good football team and we can keep getting better, obviously.
Was there a moment you felt like you guys seized the momentum for good? Because it was kind of back and forth a lot.
Yeah, it is back and forth. You know, I think good football teams, the offense has got to pick up the defense, the defense has got to pick up the offense. You know, special teams plays a factor in there too. So, yeah, just some point in the third quarter, it was I felt when we got to – hold them on the goal line down there and force them to a field goal. That was really big for us to let our offense get back out on the field, go have a long drive on them, run the ball, and get a score after that. That was a really big momentum change.
That tip from Miles, what did you see on that interception?
Well, Miles made a really good play. That should have been Miles' pick. If there was half a pick, you should give a half to Miles for that. But, yeah, Miles made a great play. They had been hitting us with that, a lot in the first half, and the ball just tipped up, and one of those things, good things happen when you're under the ball.
What do you say about him stepping in on, for like third string nickel, moving in from the corner and the game he put in today?
Yeah, I'm super proud of Miles. I mean, that just shows the type of guy he is, his work ethic during the week, you know, trying to get prepared, not playing a ton of nickel, having a little bit of nickel experience, but not a ton. It just shows how good of a football player he really is to step in and come execute a game plan and adjust during the game. And everything's not going to be perfect. I've had to step in and play nickel before, and it's not an easy thing, but Miles did a very good job. Nothing can stop me. I'm all the way up. All the way up. I'm all the way up. I'm all the way up. Nothing can stop me. I'm all the way up. Shorty, what you want? Shorty, what you need? What you need? My niggas run game. We ain't never leave.
Containing that quarterback, how difficult was that? How do you think you guys did?
Yeah, he was he is kind of an elusive quarterback. He's pretty quick, he's fast. They got the ball out really fast, so they didn't let our D-line go to work at all, really. You know, I thought we did an all right job. We let a couple scrambles go, but for the most part, besides that one in the fourth quarter, he kind of broke on us. Other than that, I felt like we did a pretty good job.
Defense, I guess, after the marquee fumble, holding them to a field goal attempt, kind of the back-to-back interception, I guess, what do you think of how you guys kind of responded to some of the adversity?
yeah, we talk about that a lot. Sudden change on defense and also just handling adversity as a team. Like that's why we do really hard workouts all summer, all winter. We talk about that every single day in the off season, and that's fighting through adversity, making the right choice when you're in that moment and not getting down and saying, hey, the defense has got to pick the offense up here, or the offense has got to pick the defense up here. So, yeah, I think that's just a culture thing that we got going here.
All right, thanks, bro.
Yeah, thank you. Thanks, guys. Oh, yeah.
Join Town Pump's Pump It Up Rewards Plus program and never pay full price for fuel again.
Save 5 cents on every gallon every day at any Town Pump across Montana.
Plus, earn and redeem points on your favorite in-store items to get free stuff with our clubs.
Stop in and pick up a rewards card. Download the Pump It Up Rewards Plus app today.
Or visit townpump.com/rewards to register and start saving.
Take us through that pick six. I mean, that you had kind of a wide open lane in the end zone there, just but take us through the seeing the ball and then going into the end zone.
I seen like they seen us bailing a lot, so it was kind of like easy to bait it, and just like I don't know, it just happened. I wasn't shocked, but I knew I was gonna make a play and it was gonna be like impactful. So to make the team like get all the energy back on our sideline. So
first in your career,
pick six, career? Yes, sir.
So yeah, I mean, just how gratifying and. What is that feeling?
It's great, actually. It's a great feeling because I know I'm going to expect more, and, like, I know the team is going to expect more out of me. So
at that point in the game, too, after they had scored and, you know, they got the ball back, I mean, how important do you think that was in the course of the game?
It was very important because they had most of the energy, and we were kind of down. But after that, it was just up from there. So.
And then, I mean, just the entire defensive effort as well today. I mean, like the fumble to hold them to a field goal. I mean, just how important were some of those?
It was great. The defense played great. It played outstanding. We had a few mistakes, but we can clean that up next week and be ready for next week. So.
And how excited were you guys for this game, knowing they're number three and you hadn't played them in a while?
Very excited. Very excited. I didn't know they didn't play them for a while, but at the same time, we would just go out there, do your job. Execute every play and do it to your fullest. So.
What kind of message is it sent to the rest of the Big Sky?
That we're coming. So, and we're like, how would I say it? We're coming to be number one and to show it like we can play and we can be up there.
7 games in, you know, at corner, I guess, how are you feeling? This season's kind of gone for you so far.
It's going great for me. Just every day get treatment, get better every day, and just lock in even more. So that's what they're hard for me. So.
What do you think of Miles filling in at nickel today?
Great. He played great. Miles had, before I came here, he had played nickel, and it showed like he played nickel and he knows what to do and helps out a lot for the defense. So
you feel like the defense – seems like first quarters have been somewhat sluggish, maybe offensively for the team, and defense kind of keeps everybody in it. Is that kind of the way you guys feel? You need to lock down?
Yes. Defense is key to the offense, I feel like, because if we don't do our job on defense, then everything can go downhill. So, but that's what we kind of harp on, to go out there, get the ball back, create a turnover for the offense, and
or just score it yourself.
Yes, sir.
All right. Thank you.
Do you have a DUI or misdemeanor conviction? If so, don't let your past hold you back. Hi, I'm attorney Dave Maldonado, and you may be eligible to have your record cleared today. Visit BigSkyDefender.com to see how.
I think I should have got my hair tied.
You want to check it out?
Huh? Okay, we can do it. Hold on, it's this side. Okay. Nah.
Your thoughts on how it went tonight? First talk about the hurdle, man. That was just fun to watch. How much fun was it to do?
It was awesome. I kind of blacked out during it. I just was kind of playing. But the O-line opened up a huge hole. And we've been talking about it all game, hitting the backside. And it was that time it was there. So I just hit it, and I knew we just needed to get it going. And the defense was doing a hell of a job getting us going on offense. And you kind of tell we were just both going back and forth, feeding off each other's energy. So it was an amazing, you know, I had so much fun with it. It was awesome, but it was all to the O-line. All right.
You said you kind of blacked out. Is that just like reactionary? Is it read and react? How does that work? You know, in that moment,
I'm going to jump over this dude. How does that work?
It's just, it's kind of like with my game, I just let my body take over, honestly. I try to eliminate all the thinking. I feel like when you start thinking at the position of running back, it's like that's when you kind of become indecisive, and then you don't make the plays, and it's now I should have did this, I should have did that. Whereas I just let it happen. I react. My body feels like I can jump over it. We're going to jump over it. If I flip, I flip. So
328 yards on the ground. So solid. It seems like cheat code kind of numbers.
Oh, yeah.
What can you say about this, you know, running back room and then also the quarterbacks running as well?
We got depth everywhere. You can see it with the quarterbacks, see it with the running backs. You know, we're down two guys right now. Love you guys, by the way. We're down two guys with Elijah and Lane, but they're going to be back. But the O-line, I'm speechless. Like, they do the job. They wear on the D-line. They make them run all across the field. Tommy makes them run all across the field. And then not only in the run game, talk about the pass game, we got our weapons back. Now you got to worry about everybody else. So it's amazing. I'm truthfully honored to be here and to be a part of this team.
Coach Johnson talked this week about wearing out the other team. Do you feel like you guys did that by the end of the game?
I think it took a while. They still had energy, as you could see, all the way up until pretty much until they gave the ball back to us on the fourth down. But you could see they had that little bit of life in them still that they wanted to keep going and win this game. But like you said, we run the ball. You just keep pounding and pounding and pounding. And the way we're built, we're Bobcat built. The way we're built, we just endure that and keep going and keep going and keep going. So,
you think that's key to why you guys are able to not let certain plays or falling down in a game like this and just be able to respond and end up building an 18-point lead?
I think it all comes into preparation. Everything we've done in the summer, everything we did in the spring, the winter, all of that comes into factor now. Nobody had to run P2. And I can tell you firsthand, P2 is crazy. So, listen, the coaches do a hell of a job putting us in situations where it's going to be uncomfortable and making us feel comfortable in uncomfortable situations. So I think all the preparation that we put in, all the work that we put in, all the coaches, all the work they put in, that all led up to being the reason why we did what we did. So.
First time you guys trailed early in a game this year. How do you guys think? How do you think, you know, the team responded when it was kind of a slow start for you guys?
You know, there's always going to be things we got to clean up, go back and look at the film. But I think we responded very well. The great thing that I think about this team is there's a lot of leaders here that you got in Danny, you got in Nola, you got in Trey, you got in Snell, all types of guys where it's like they know how to get everybody going. And then they also know how to calm us down and be like, listen, let's focus and let's do our job. So I really think it's the culture we have here. It's just everybody can trust each other. Everybody can lean on each other to get the job done, no matter who the ball, where the ball goes, doesn't matter.
Good.
Join Town Pump's Pump It Up Rewards Plus program and never pay full price for fuel again.
Save 5 cents on every gallon every day at any Town Pump across Montana.
Plus, earn and redeem points on your favorite in-store items to get free stuff with our clubs.
Stop in and pick up a rewards card. Download the Pump It Up Rewards Plus app today.
Or visit townpump.com/rewards to register and start saving. Town.